In this video, I'll be showing you how to make a simple menu component in Godot. I use it for all the menus in my game, as well as the Choices menu in my Dialog Manager add-on. Let's get started. I'll be walking you through how to build this general purpose menu component with a moving pointer sprite, but if you just want a finished version, then the code files for this are available to my patrons. That code also includes a few extra things that aren't covered in this tutorial. There's a link to my Patreon page down below. Okay, so the menu itself is just a VBox container, so make a new script that extends a VBox container. The items in the menu will be some of the VBox container's children, so let's make a method for working out what the items will be. I do this because I don't just want all children to be counted as selectable items. We might want to have headings or dividers in there so we can use the node names to help filter them out. We also want to filter out anything that isn't a control because we won't be able to focus any non-control things. So our function will look something like this. And now that we have that, the next step is to set up the item focus chain. You could set this up manually per menu, but I prefer to have it configured automatically based on the order of the controls in the node tree. To set up the focus, we iterate over any selectable items and set their focus properties to point to the correct neighbors. If it's the first item in the list, then we have no upper neighbor, so it points to itself. Otherwise, it points to the previous item. If we are the first node, we also grab focus initially. Then, if it's the last item, we do something similar. Otherwise, it's the next item in the list. If you wanted to set up selection wrapping, then you could change the first item's previous neighbor to point to the last item in the items list, and then the last item's next neighbor to be the first item. But I'm not doing that for this. Now that we have this configure focus method, we can call it in the ready method. So while we are in the ready method, we should also connect to the viewport's focus change signal. So let's do that. This handler will be called for all focus changes in the viewport, so we first need to make sure that the control being focused is actually part of this menu. If it is, then we can update the position of the pointer. But first, we need to actually have a pointer, so let's add an export variable to define one. Now, back inside the focus changed handler, add a call to update selection. That method doesn't exist yet, so let's make it. First, we get the currently focused item. Then, we make sure we have a valid item and a valid pointer before setting the position of the pointer to be next to the focused item. You might notice that this getFocusedItem method also doesn't exist, so let's make it now. All it has to do is get the currently focused control within the viewport and then filter to make sure it's actually a child of this menu. Now that all the setup is done, the last thing we need to do is make it so you can actually pick something from the menu. We do that by overriding the unhandled input method. I first checked to make sure this menu is even visible before accepting any input. If so, then we mark the input as handled. Assuming our menu is on top of everything, then this will consume all input so anything else in the viewport will be ignored. Next, we get the currently focused item like we did earlier. If there is a focused item and we have just pressed the UE accept action, then we can emit an action signal, which I should also define. And now that we have a menu, let's try it out. In a new scene, we can add a menu node and put some labels on it. We can also then link a sprite node to use as our pointer. Now, let's give it a whirl. So you can see selections are working here. Now we can connect to our signal that we set up before to know when something is actually chosen. Let's see that in action. So you can see when I'm pressing enter, it's actioning the currently selected item. And that's pretty much it for building a simple menu. As always, if you have a question, then drop it in a comment below or join my Discord for a chat. I'll see you there, or I'll see you here again soon. Bye.